Preview.
Kim Jong-un secret trip to China. It's being confirmed now. He's there. Now, I don't know how long he's going to be there or when he's going to go back, but he took a secret train. His father did this 7 years ago before he died. And now apparently Kim Jong-un has done the same thing. Just amazing what's taking place right now. But Kim Jong-un is in China. Now, let's tell you what's been said. Kim Jong-un is making a surprise China visit, according to sources. This is the first trip outside the isolated state since taking power in 2011. The mysterious move comes weeks after President Trump agreed to meet with Kim Jong-un. So there's a deal in the making. You can know this, that Trump and Kim Jong-un are going to put a deal together, and this is part of this process, in my opinion. Matter of fact, I'll tell you my opinion in just a second. Kim Jong-un made a surprise visit to Beijing on his first known trip outside of North Korea since taking power in 2011. Three people with knowledge of the visit are saying. Further details of his trip include how long Kim would stay and who he would meet, and were not immediately available, but the people asked not to be identified because of the sensitivity of this information. Yeah, they don't want to be killed by Kim Jong-un when he gets back home. Speculation is a possible visit by a high-ranking North Korean official circulated around the capital of Beijing, China, today. After Japan's Kyodo News reported that a special train may have carried Kim Jong-un through the northeastern border city of Dandong, and according to Nippon TV, it showed footage of a train arriving today in Beijing, China, that looked very similar to the same one used by Kim Jong-un's father, Kim Jong-il, who went to China for a visit just before he died in 2011. The unannounced visit is the latest in a series of diplomatic power plays going on in Asia as the United States President Donald J. Trump's battle to lower the U.S. trade deficit becomes entangled with his effort to get Kim Jong-un to give up his nuclear weapons. China's President Xi Jinping has found himself preparing for a trade war with Trump even after supporting progressive rounds of the United Nations sanctions against Kim Jong's regime. Yeah, but guys, he might have supported it, but we know he was selling Kim Jong-un oil and a lot of other stuff. They were transferring it from Chinese boats into North Korean boats in the middle of the ocean. We know the Russians were doing it also, and we know that Iran was doing it also. We've got pictures and satellite feed and everything of these guys. So don't be fooled by this stuff. And so when you're reading the Bloomberg, which is a Bloomberg report, or any left-wing leaning liberal newspaper or article, know that they're slanting the story, usually almost always. And then they call us fake news. The U.S. appears to have no advance knowledge of Kim's visit. Again, you know we know about the visit. We're probably the ones that orchestrated it. The White House deputy press secretary, though, told reporters today that he couldn't confirm the reports of the trip. We don't know if they're necessarily true. That means they're true. Okay. And the State Department spokesman, Julia Mason, responded to questions about the report with a single sentence. We'd refer you to the Chinese. It's true. Okay. So what I'll just state, though, is that where we are with North Korea is in a better place than we used to be because the president's maximum pressure campaign, in conjunction with dozens of other countries around the world, has paid dividends and has brought North Korea to the table.